In this video, I teach you it comparisons between fire tube and water tube boilers. I teach you 11 points in this video in such a way that you can understand these 11 points easily. So first point is that on the basis of positions of water and hot gases. So first column is for particulates, second column is for fire tube, and the third column is for the water tubes. Particular means on the basis of which point I explain these comparisons or a difference. So positions of water and hot gas. So here this is a one boiler. So this is the boiler cell. Inside this boiler, this is a tube and this is a furnace. Okay. So hot gases from the furnace is supplied inside the tube. Okay. And water is outside the tube or it is in cell. So this boiler is known as the fire tube boiler. Means whatever the name of the boiler, it is inside the tube. That's why it is known as the fire tube boiler. So flue gases passes through the tube and the water outside the tube, it is known as the fire tube. Another is the water tube boiler. So this is the figure. This is a complete cell. This is the furnace and this is the various pipe. So water is entering this pipe. Okay. And the gases is outside the pipe. That's why it is known as the water tube boiler, because water is inside the tube. So whatever particle is inside, means water is inside the tube, then it is known as water tube. Fire is inside the tube, then it is known as the fire tube boiler. So this is the first comparison. Second comparison is on the basis of operating pressure. Means boiler is working on which pressure, it is known as the operating pressure. So fire tube boiler is operate at the limited to 25 bar, means up to 25 bar fire tube boiler is work. And water tube boiler can work under as high pressure as more than 125 bar. Okay. So this is the range of pressure for both the boiler. Third is on the basis of scale depositions and overheating. Now what is the scale depositions? Okay. Means when the anything used with the water, it start to depositions. That is known as the scale depositions. Here I show you some images. Okay. This is the boiler and this is the side view of the boiler. Okay. And here that is a one head component, but that is open. Okay. So when the boiler is water tube, means water is passing inside the boiler, means in this case of water tube, that is a small deposition of scale will be cause overheating and bursting of the tubes. Okay. Means inside the tube, that is a scale deposition. That is a one image of this pipe. So inside the pipe, this type of the scaling is done. And due to the scaling, that is a overheating is happen. And the area of the water is also reduced. So this causes the lots of problems. But in fire tube boiler, what happened? The water is outside the tube and the fire is inside the tube. Means there is a no water inside the tube. So no problem of scale depositions and less problem of overheating and bursting. So in a water tube boiler, water is flowing inside the tubes. Okay. That's create the problem of scaling, and due to the scaling, overheating is done. Okay. So this scaling is inside the tube, so it is also difficult to clean. Okay. And in a fire tube boiler, scaling is done outside, so it is easily cleanable. So this is the main point of using of the fire tube boiler instance of water tube boiler. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels by pressing the subscribe button. Next is rate of steam generation. Means how amount of the steam is generated per hour. That is in meter cube per hours or liter per hours. Okay. So in fire tube, it have a lower rate of steam generations and water tube have a higher rate of steam generation. Next point is according to the suitability. Means where it is suitable. So fire tube is not suitable for larger power plants, where the water tube boiler is suitable for larger power plant because it's have a higher pressure. That's why it is a more suitable for larger place and the fire tube is suitable for a smaller applications. Next point is chances of explosion, means chances of blast or chances of collapse of the boiler. So fire tube boiler, that is a less chances due to the lower pressure, and water tube have a more chances due to the high pressure. In the last point what we studying, the fire tube is limited to 25 bar. So it have a low chance. But in water tube, that is a pressure is more than 125 bar. So the water tube boiler have more chances of blast or explosions compared to the fire tube. Next point is floor space requirement. So fire tube boilers are require more space and water tube boiler are required less space. So how we can explain these things? So in a water tube, that is a pressure is more than 125 bar, and in fire tube that is only 25 bar. So when we are required to the higher pressure, at that time we are required a higher thickness of the pipe, okay, and we are required a lower space, because when the pressure is increased, the volume of the particular substance is also reduced. That why water tube boilers are required a less space requirement, because this pressure is higher. Due to pressure, the volume of the water and steam is reduced. That's why it's required a lower space. Why the fire tubes are required a more space, and reason is opposite to the water tube. Reason is that it is limited to 25 bar compared to the water tube boiler. So it's required a larger space. That's why it is known as the fire tube boiler. What is the cost? The cost of the fire tube boiler is less and water tube boiler is higher. So how we can justify this reason? So in the last step, we studied that the pressure is higher in water tube boiler. Okay, so when the pressure is higher, we require a larger size, larger thickness of the pipe or a larger thickness of the cell. Okay, so larger thickness of the pipe and a cell, it increase the cost of the water tube boiler. In a fire tube boiler, the pressure is near to 25 bar. So compared to the water tube boiler, fire tube are required the less thickness of the tube and the cell. Then less thickness, then the less material cost, then its overall cost of the fire tube boiler is reduced. So these are the reasons for cost of the water tube boiler and fire tube boiler. Next point is requirement of the skill. Fire tube boiler required the less skill for efficient and economic working. Means for operating these fire tube boilers, it's required the less skill for efficient and economic working. In a water tube boilers, we are require more skill and careful attentions for efficient and economic working. Means that is a high skill worker is required for a water tube boiler, and for a fire tube boiler, the less skill operator is required. Next point is the use of the boiler. So fire tube boiler is used for producing a process steam. Means steam produced by the fire tube boiler is used in the different textile processing or a different industries. Okay, means it is not used for the power generation. In water tube boiler, producing steam for the power generation as well as the process heating. Means water tube boiler is used in power plant as well as for a process heating. And the last point is the examples. Fire tube boilers example is Cochran boiler and locomotive are types of fire tube boilers. And water tube boiler example is the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.